They once dominated the way we used to travel, signalling their presence across the landscape in clouds of boiler steam and soot. But the locomotive engines that roamed the rail lines of the state are now worn, tired and in need of a place to rest. And there's a new home for them in Sydney's west.
After almost 80 years of service to the state, it was time for Loco 2606 to lie back as she travelled through the night to her new retirement home.
We've got plenty of examples like these that really pushed on past the 100-year mark.
She would haul coal until 1970 after failing to muster the Caledonian Puff to surmount the Great Dividing Range.
Initially used on the Penrith line up the Blue Mountains, unfortunately the design didn't quite work out. The railways in Scotland and England specifically are like billiard tables compared to New South Wales.
And along with 5096...
They really were the workhorses, the semi-trailer, if you like, of their day.
And 1219...
Steam locomotives don't have gears, so how they get the higher speed is the bigger wheels.
...were delicately lifted, then transported to their new home at Chullora. A new heritage hub and centralised storage facility for the state's historic rolling stock that will become the ultimate restoration centre for true rail nuts, known as gunzels.
Getting them under cover and out of the weather will aid their preservation for the long term.
So they had great longevity, these machines.
And the good news is, if we restore some of them and get them going again, they'll be able to traverse up and down through the Hunter, down to the south coast and back.
Given shelter from the elements, these elderly outdoor cats now allowed indoors.
So many people I meet on our railways right now have been inspired to work in the industry because of the magic of this heritage.
In Chullora, Mike Dalton, 9 News.